Odysseus' days of wandering lost had finally come to an end. deep in the chasms, Brontes, the lurking betrayer, awaiting.
Hephaistos' assistant? Who made my thunder? The first time I met him at the party, his eye followed me everywhere I went. It was awkward. I had to leave early.
You just can't let me build tension, can you? Applaud the warrior on her achievement?
Shield bearer.
Thank you.
This is hopeless.
Fenyx is about to rectify that situation.
Ha!
was retrieved.
What I did to protect what little hope was left in this world. It was too fragile to be trusted to Hephaistos, let alone mankind.
And yet, look at them now. Your son is stronger than you ever believed him to be. As is Fenyx.
All of it. Let's start again. Maybe we got off on the wrong foot.
Is that a joke? Oh, sure. Everyone have a good laugh at the disabled god.
Gods, I'm so bad at apologies. I always wind up putting my foot in my mouth.
Seriously? How much foot material do you have?
What's worse is I was about to quote, Zeno of Gideon, huh? It's better to trip with your feet
than with your tongue. Not funny, but at least it fits the context. But if you say something stupid like you found your footing, we're done.
You've come back.
Hope in hand.
May it spread wide. You've brought so much more to this old god than hope. I doubted my worth. Everyone did. But that doubt did not make me weak. It made me strong. I was the greatest creator to ever plunge metal into flame. For my doubts always forced me to push myself to greater heights. Because of you, I am that again. And maybe a little prouder for it.
Anything's better than arting, right?
I commit myself to rebuilding this world with you. And when this is over, maybe you could help me destroy some of that art. You are the first friend I've had in a long, long time. The first of many. Thank you, young Fenyx.
May the light of 1,000 forges guide your way, big guy.
May the light of 1,000 forges guide your way.
Thank you.
With all four crests of the Fallen, Fenyx could now pass through the mysterious door. Inside the Tomb of the Heroes, Fenyx could feel the presence of the great mortal warriors of old, summoned to the Golden Isle to fight Typhon.
What a bunch of turncoats!
Achilles, known as the war hero to all heroes, had an unconquerable hubris too easily stoked by Typhon.
I can't look at that sweet, sweet face! Betrayer! No, wait, just one more glance.
Atalanta, insatiable huntress with a strength of mind and body unmatched. But the master of the axe lost her way, and her distraction caused her demise. Then only Heracles and Odysseus remain. One, the divine epitome of masculine prowess, and the other, a king with unparalleled intelligence. They fought hard. But Typhon outwitted Heracles' brute strength, and Odysseus, driven mad by inadequacy when he couldn't best Typhon, fell like the rest. Long would they suffer under Typhon's grip, until Fenyx came to set them free and surprise us all.
For now.
Fenyx ascended towards the mysterious room, a place where heroism passes into eternity.
For a guy trying to get unchained from a rock, you sure do like to stop and chew on the scene.
Ah!
An empty pedestal?
One fit for a hero.
I can't believe it. I'll try to be worthy of this. I swear it.